Hey guys, welcome back. Hope you have watched the previous video with a basic understanding of assertiveness. If not, hit the I button now on the top right corner or find the video link in the description. In this video, let's learn a bit more. To start with, let's bust some myths about assertiveness. These will make it easy for us to be more assertive. Also, there are some people who use these myths unknowingly to become non-assertive, so it's worth taking a look. Myth 1. Assertiveness and aggressiveness are the same. No, these are not the same. This is thought so mainly by the aggressive people. Both aggressive and assertive people state what their needs are, so it should be the same. That's their assumption. However, the words, the approach, the body language, and the tone used are totally different in aggressive as well as assertiveness. Myth 2. I must be assertive always or in every situation. Being assertive is a choice. You may not have to be assertive always. For example, if someone is high on alcohol, becomes aggressive or violent on you, what would you do? Well, being assertive in such a situation could be like inviting unnecessary risk. This is so because the other person is not rational. So here, being passive and leaving the place could be more beneficial. Meaning, assertive people are brilliant enough to handle the situation as well. Myth 3. I'll get what I want if I am assertive. Let's understand this. We may not get what we want always if we are assertive. There's no guarantee of even an outcome always. If you're assertive, you express your needs rightly along with respecting others' needs. Sometimes you get what you want, sometimes you may not, and sometimes you crack a mutual agreement. That could be more important. That was about myth briefly. Now let's look at what happens if you are unassertive. There have been many researchers to find the negative effects of being unassertive. If you continuously communicate aggressively, you will eventually lose the loved ones and lose friends. There have been cases wherein the best performing professionals lost their cool and be aggressive with managers, and well, you could guess what would have happened there. They even mess up their personal life. Ultimately, they could lose their self-esteem. What happens if you are passive? If we have a passive approach, we are not expressing what we want. This makes us to agree for others' needs more and losing to look at our own needs. This always makes us empty, and we will be left with just the thoughts like, I should have done that, or I should have said that. Only regrets, you see. But when the time comes again, we miss to tell the same things for the fear which does not exist. All in all, this makes us tensed, anxious, stressed, or even resentful with lots of things unsaid. Many passives suffer social phobia because of this. They feel people could be critical or judgmental about them, and the result being avoiding the social situations. They don't like more people. But you could be thinking, what makes us unassertive? If you're really thinking about this, then you're in the right path, my friend. Because did you know assertiveness is a learned behavior and thinking style? The fact is, we are born assertive. Let's take an example. Think of a baby. Babies cry when they want something. Their emotions are expressed freely. Later, while growing up, they adapt to the environment and start changing the responses they receive from maybe family, friends, neighbors, classmates, colleagues, and their seniors at office. It's important to not to blame family of yourself for not being assertive. It's good to look at what you are doing to address it and become more assertive. For this, you need to understand what stops us from becoming assertive, and that will be discussed in the next video. Stay tuned. Don't miss to be assertive in liking, sharing, and subscribing to Campus Reach Out. Keep learning, happy learning. See you soon.